Well, that was some boring music.
Spike?
Come on, where's the Justin Bieber? Where's the Katy Perry? Where's the Fallout Boy?
Noddle, you have witch powers. Turn him into a chipmunk and feed him to the owl outside.
I will do no such thing. We're here to talk about our website.
HomeCanineNeutering.com?
What?
No! InvaderPet.com, where people can check out our comic strips or locate bookstores selling bookmarks with our comics on them. So, listeners, want to see comics of me, Noddle the Witch, my pets Kaylee Cat and Spike Beagle? Go to InvaderPet.com and check us out!
Seriously, though, you guys really have a canine neutering website?
Hey, everyone. Want to know how you can help Let's Talk About the Music stay on the air and earn some VIP privileges at the same time? Go to patreon.com/LTATMradio to find out how you can get involved. That's patreon.com. Let's Talk About the Music.
Magical Things offers fantasy art for festival and everyday living, featuring the fine arts and craft creations of Marjorie Delaney on practical printed products such as journals, mugs, costuming, wearable art, formal wear, and accessories. We also carry a line of magical supplies, including candles, oils, herbs, and limited ritual items. All items are created in a scenic studio space in Culpeper, Virginia, and available throughout the world online, as well as at festivals and events. Magical Things offers custom creations too, such as costuming, illustrations, and more. Come visit us at magicalfantasy.com.
Who did this sound effect? Oh my, I wonder who did this? Join Spider and myself, Shels, on Let's Talk About the Music on August 10th at 8 p.m. Pacific Standard Time and find out. This is very intriguing. I wonder who did this.
I'll introduce you to my ride. line aboard the Seduction 747. And this plane is fully equipped with anything your body desires. If for any reason there's a loss in cabin pressure, I will automatically drop down to apply more. And to activate the flow of excitement, extinguish all my clothing materials and pull my body close to yours. Place my lips over your mouth and kiss, kiss my lips. In the event there's overexcitement, your seat cushion may be used as a flotation device. Anticipate a few turbulence along the way. We are now making our final approach to satisfaction. Please bring your lips, your arms, your hips into the upped and locked position. Until the aircraft has come to a complete stop. Thank you for flying Prince International.
Oh, 21 seconds. Okay, I got you.
Hey, those Prince International lover. And that's what the show is about. This show is about Prince, and not only about Prince, it's about Prince tributes and covers. This is Let's Talk About the Music Spotlight, and I am Spider. Yay!
I'm
gotta give myself a yay every time, just because, you know, I feel like giving myself a yay.
Go for it.
What do you think, Shels?
Yeah, go for it. Yay!
Shels is co-hosting the special Spotlight event on the other side of the chairs.
Mm-hmm.
And once again, we have our guest.
Excited.
Oh, I'm
she's kind of like about the whole thing still.
She said that was an excited kind of thing going on.
Nice.
If you would have said, "Hey, we're back on the air with Duran Duran," she would have been like, "You say Prince?" She's like, like you just gave her cotton candy or something.
Uh huh, it's Prince.
Of course, we've got Julian here. Julian is our guest tonight. He is part of the tribute band Erotic City, a tribute to Prince. Hello again, Julian.
Hello, my funky friends.
And we've been talking about not only just about Prince in general, but we've been talking about Erotic City and how they got started. And now we're going to talk about stage shows. Stage shows, the real meaty, interesting stuff. How do your stage shows usually go, Julian?
Our stage shows usually run like the way I experienced them when I seen Prince for the first time. Very exciting, very high energy, very how can I say this? It's almost like meeting a woman for the first time and she's about to give it to you. And you know she's going to give it to you really good. So it's kind of like that kind of excitement. You know, you're sitting there, you're like, oh, my freaking God, this is about to happen. You know, oh, yeah, you know. So it's got, and this is the experience I felt in the crowd ever since I've been to my very first Prince concert. These women are screaming at the top of their lungs, and you want to tell them, shut up, I'm trying to hear the music. They're like, screw you. You know, I'm, I can't control myself. And I noticed that that kind of excitement is what's needed at every show for any kind of artist. If they're not creating that kind of excitement from the Beatles to anybody else you've seen in our generations of time, then something's kind of wrong. You know what I mean? Because music is supposed to deliver that excitement. And Prince kind of captured all of that. And he kept it. You know, what, no matter what he did or how he did it, these fans were extremely excited. Just watch him walk in a room or jump on stage or do whatever. He didn't have to do anything. Just walk and say, hey, I'm here to say, and thus, R&B artists. And people are screaming at the top of their lungs. They're going to, we don't care about the freaking artist you're representing. We just want to see you. That's excitement.
Mm. Now, so I knew that. Do your stage shows here. What area do you usually focus on? Do you try to cover his entire career, or do you try to stick
No, it's impossible to do that. And I kind of realized that what people recognize the most is the early career, I would say, from Controversy through maybe, you know, around Diamonds and Pearls. Mm. Kind of era, at least to me.